Definitely one of the most common questions I get on my channel, when will PUBG run at 60 frames per second on console? And to those questions, I really don't have a great answer. Mainly because while you're playing, it still struggles to run at 30 frames per second. I think these questions and this discussion still spawns from the very beginning. Before it even came out on Xbox, Brendan Green sent out a tweet saying he got the game to run at 60 frames per second on the Xbox One X, but they could only squeeze out 30 to 40 frames per second on the standard console. So clearly they had an unlocked frame rate and he was seeing that. Now was he actually on an official Xbox One X or was he on one of the dev kits that they give to developers at times? And if you don't know, the dev kits that they give usually have higher specs so that developers can kind of gradually tone their game down to meet the requirements. At that time, he also indicated that they're still trying to get the standard console up to 60 frames per second, but it looks like it won't happen before launch. Now this was tweeted out sometime in November of 2017, with the launch coming December 12th of 2017. And we all know for sure, on launch day, that the game was not running at 60 frames per second, and it wasn't even running at 30 frames per second. He said, definitely on Xbox One X, 60 frames per second. On Xbox One, we're not sure. We may have to limit it at 30 frames per second, maybe, but the last time I saw it, it was running at about 30 or 40. We're still constantly improving it, so you know, the aim is to get to 60. Now obviously that's every PUBG console player's dream. Get the game to 60 frames per second, and just think how much better this game would be to play at double the frame rate. But then a short while later, he backtracked and tweeted this out. While I previously stated PUBG would run at a higher FPS at Xbox game preview launch on 12/12, I want to clarify that PUBG will run at 30 frames per second across all Xbox One devices. We're constantly refining the game and exploring options to increase FPS, but this is early in development and we're unable to confirm more. So I have a feeling that maybe he was seeing an Xbox One X run at 60 FPS. Maybe it was in a very enclosed environment with only a couple players. Maybe it was a dev kit, like I said, which is way more powerful than the standard consoles that we can get. I don't think that he was lying by any means, but I think he was indeed hopeful that we could get this game to 60 frames per second. Let me show you what PUBG on Xbox looks like at 60 frames per second, or something close to it anyway. Now, you might have noticed something about that video. It was sped up to 2x speed, and that's really the only way we can get the console footage from Xbox One X to run at 60 frames per second is to just double the speed, but unfortunately we can't play at double the speed. But that's what it would look like if we could slow it down a little bit, and it just looks so smooth and so great, and I wish we could have that. We wouldn't have known that we would have had so many issues that we did over the year that we've been playing this game so far, but at this point I think the game is in a very good place. It's running mostly at 30 FPS. There's definitely some dips, I'm not gonna lie. If you go near a smoke grenade, or if you go near a Molotov after it's been thrown, your frame rates are going to at least go down to 25, sometimes even 20, I imagine. I don't have a counter on my screen, and there's no way I can actually tell that, but you can just tell that the game is chunking at that point, and it's just struggling to get by. And I play on the Xbox One X, so if you're a standard Xbox One user, you have it even worse. But I think that's the main reason that we get these questions from people all the time. Will the Xbox version, will the PS4 version of the game ever run at 60 frames per second? And I think usually what I say is, I doubt it. I'd just like to see the game first run at a rock steady 30 FPS. I know that sounds terrible for a lot of people, especially PC players, and they'll mock the console players even if we say that that's okay. We just want the 30 FPS to stay at 30 FPS, not have as many dips as we do, not have as many problems. But I'd love to see 60 FPS in PUBG. It would change the game completely. It would be so smooth to play. You'd be able to spot enemies quicker. You'd be able to adjust your aim better. You'd be able to hit moving targets much better. Everything is just so much smoother. If you haven't played a proper 60 frames per second game and played it as a competitive game, then you're missing out because there's nothing really like it. You can't play Halo 5 at 60 FPS or Call of Duty or Battlefield at 60 FPS and then go to a game like PUBG and not notice a big difference. Do I believe that eventually we'll get 60 FPS on at least the Xbox One X and the PS4 Pro? Honestly, I don't think so. I just don't think it's going to happen. I'd love for them to prove me wrong, and I think with this latest update that they gave on the PUBG forums, they're trying to do something about that. So they started a new edition on the PUBG forums for the console players, for both Xbox and PS4. They call it the Console Dev Report, and they're going to be replacing the weekly community posts that they were having before. This one is all about frame rates and what they're doing to try and improve it and try and make it go past even 30 frames per second. So they start off by basically saying that players are reporting frame drops, especially during late stages where there are frequent close quarter combat situations. And unfortunately, that's when you need the frames the most. You need them in those close quarter combat situations when everything's on the line and there's multiple people you're shooting at. You need the best frame rate possible to try and survive and try and hit your shots. But unfortunately, that's when PUBG kind of tanks the most. Unless you're, like I said before, in smoke or near fire or in a vehicle, where the game tanks the most is when there's multiple enemies around and it's a close quarters fight. If you're fighting somebody from over 100 meters away and you're just popping shots, you'll probably have no problem. There'll be no dips or dives or anything like that. But if you're right on a couple players and you have to fight for your life, that's when the game's gonna tank, and unfortunately, that's when you need it the most. They say that PUBG calculates resources of everything within a 600 meter radius of the character. So when we get in a late game, when the zone's super small, there's more players in a small circle and more resources that need to be calculated. And they also mention that's why we have some issues at hot drops, because there's so many players in a small area, they have to calculate all this data within 600 meters of every single player in that area. And that's what causes the frame drops and the very laggy feel at times. So to improve the performance and reduce the rate of frame drops in these situations, they're going to lower the resources needed to be calculated. So basically they define this view spectrum of your player. So what you can actually see and what you can't see. And what they're going to want to do is only calculate the things that your player could actually see. The things that you can't see, they'll only calculate the things that you absolutely need, like the sound of a player's footsteps, the sound of a vehicle. But they can leave visual things aside because you can't see them anyway. If you turn around, then they'll need to calculate that data. But if you are just facing north and there's people south of you, they don't have to calculate every single thing about the person or the environment behind you because you're not seeing it anyway. It's just going to hopefully lighten the load on the servers, especially in those close quarter situations. Now they go into some pretty great detail about this stuff, so if you guys want to read into this, I'll have this link in the description below. It's actually pretty interesting to see how much goes into this. If you're not familiar with game development, I'm not very familiar with it, but man, it gets really complicated really fast. They have to calculate a lot of information in very small areas, and I think that's why we're seeing so many issues. But it looks like they've been testing this, and they said with 30 bots, they're seeing much better performance after the change is made. We'll just get incremental changes over time that will gradually improve the frame rate, and then hopefully we get it to at least a steady 30, and then we'll see if they can actually push it beyond that. I'm definitely interested to see if they can actually push this thing beyond 30 frames per second. If they could get it up to 60 frames per second on the Xbox One X and PS4 Pro, I think that would be just amazing, but I also think at the same time, it would be a pretty big disadvantage for normal Xbox One or Xbox One S players or normal PS4 players, because I don't think they're going to be hitting that 60 frames per second target. I know in the next PTS server, we're going to get some graphic options. So this also might be something that they can tweak and kind of use to their benefit. If you lower the graphic options enough, maybe you get better frame rates, which obviously will be the case. But how high will those frame rates go? Will we ever see what Brendan Green said he saw on the Xbox One X? PUBG running at 60 FPS on console? I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see. Unfortunately, only time will tell. But let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. I can definitely understand if people get frustrated and leave this game because there's some things about it that make you so mad at times and it just seems so unfair. And then all the while, if the frame rate is tanking on you in important situations, it just makes it that much more frustrating. I'm definitely still having a blast with it. My friends and I still play it 4 or 5 times a week, if not more, so this game's not going anywhere. I am excited for some games that are coming out in the future, but PUBG is not going to be replaced by any one certain game. Like I said in a previous video, the only game that can kill PUBG is PUBG itself, because there's just something about it that makes it different and unique. But at the same time, people can only take so much. And if it keeps toiling around and we never get up to a solid 30 frames per second, or if we never even get a hint of things getting improved, we may lose players, and with that, we may lose some of the fun. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to stay up to date on everything PUBG console. I also want to continue covering Anthem, and then I have Vigor as well. When more news comes out on that, I'll be making more videos that way. So just hit subscribe to make sure you're staying up to date on everything that I put out. Remember to follow me on Twitter and join my Discord. The links are in the description below. But with that being said, I hope you guys have a good rest of your day. Until next time, I'll see you later.